Switch on, friends. Good morning. Yes, India is facing a challenge. Indians are facing a challenge. And I think it's extremely important for you and I at this junction to spread stories of gladness. The mass media is filled with things that will make you mad or sad. But I strongly feel that we have to look for reasons why we can be glad by actually either doing things that makes other people glad or sharing stories of people who are adding to gladness. So here I like to share a beautiful conversation I recently had about a week back with a very dear person. His name is Shekhar Thapiyal. Although I have only known him for the past few months, only met him once, but he actually is very dear to me because of the things he does. So when I was having a chat with him last week, I asked him where he was, and he said he was just leaving the hospital because he was there in the hospital to encourage his aunt in the ICU because she more or less had given up, and he actually invested a good amount of time that he was allowed to be with the aunt during those hours. Somehow he managed to get into the ICU and really pumped her up, and he feels that now the aunt feels encouraged and she's doing everything she can to overcome the challenge. And he's actually now moving back home, and like that he said, I'm looking for other relatives who I can help, even if they're not as extreme cases as to be sent into the ICU. But he says, I see many relatives whose grown-up children have settled overseas, and for multiple reasons, the kids are not able to be with the parents. So sometimes aging people, right, although they may have money, but if they don't have the presence of their loved ones, especially their children, they feel sad. So he says, I'm doing everything in my power to do what I can to be with them, if possible, even physically. So I said, aren't you afraid that you may also be infected? And he said something powerful. He says, I take abundant precaution. I wear multiple masks. I'm cleaning my hands. I do maintain as much distance as I can when I'm meeting such people. But also I have a feeling, jab tak chabi bhari Ram ne, tab tak chale khilona. So gentlemen and ladies, you know, spreading such news about such people, that would empower you. So I strongly feel that let's not call the bad situation very, very bad. It'll actually act to the contrary and reduce our will and the desire to overcome the challenge. So going forward, I'll again like to share another story that would make you glad, a true story. And this is something I came across a few years back, and I keep this in my mind. And similarly, I have many other stories that I think about when I'm feeling a bit sad or even mad. A glad story. So a father with limited means promises his daughter that if she were to study hard and do well in the 10th board exams, he will treat her to a restaurant meal experience. So the daughter studies very, very hard, does extremely well, and as promised, the father takes her to a restaurant. Now, they're sitting face to face, the daughter's very happy, she's made the father proud, and soon the waiter comes, places a glass of water each in front of the daughter and the father, and says, sir, may I take your order? So the man says, before I give you the order, young man, allow me to share the occasion why we are here, the daughter and the father. I promised my daughter if she works hard, does well in the 10th board exams, I'll bring her to this restaurant, right, and treat her for a lovely dosa and a coffee. And he says, now, allow me to give you the order, young man. Please bring a hot masala dosa and a cup of hot filter coffee. And then the waiter looks at the man. He says, only one? He says, just a moment. So he smiles at his daughter, gets up and guides the waiter away from the table and whispers into his ears. He says, young man, I'm a father with limited means. I don't have the money to buy two dosas and two coffees. So today I just want my daughter to enjoy the dosa and the coffee of this wonderful restaurant. I'll go home and have my breakfast. So he peels away from the waiter, comes and sits down. He's smiling. The daughter's very, very happy. And guess what? The waiter is overwhelmed by this, the commitment of the father, the sincerity and the humility. So he goes to the owner of the restaurant who's sitting at the cash register and says, sir, this is what I just experienced. And I strongly feel that the father should also be having the dosa and the coffee along with the daughter. And since he feels that he doesn't have the means, sir, if you would allow me, I will contribute from my tips of today to pay for his dosa and coffee. Listening to this, the restaurant owner said, you will do nothing of this sort. Relax. Order for the two dosas and the two coffees for that table and it'll be on the house. Okay? Relax. So he goes in and he's very, very happy that the owner is sensitive and sensible. And the owner gets up from his cash register, goes towards the desk where the father and the daughter is sitting, smiles at them, congratulates the father and the daughter, and takes permission to sit next to them. And then he looks at the father and says, Sir, I'm very, very happy. And I'm honored that you've chosen my restaurant to come and celebrate the success of your daughter. So kindly allow me to be a good uncle, and this would be a small treat from the restaurant. And guess what? He peels away. So the father and the daughter obviously accept this present. And soon they've done eating the dosa and the coffee. And as they're getting up and they're moving towards the cash register to thank the uncle, the uncle also gets up. He says, thank you very much once again. He gives best wishes to the young lady and hands them four boxes of sweets. He says, sir, will you kindly distribute these sweets to your neighbors, friends and family? And before you leave, there's one more request I have. This is a box of sweets I would want you to please distribute to my customers. Because coming from a man like you, so sincere, I would really want you to distribute a sweet each to people who are here sitting in different tables, my customers, because when they receive the sweet from you, it would be like a prasad. And then he gets up and makes announcement of the lady having done wonderfully well, and the father would be there to distribute sweets to actually share the happiness the family is experiencing. So the father does that, and the father and the daughter leave the restaurant, and the story is not yet over, but I'm sure the story already is making you glad. Many years later, one fine day, a phone comes and the restaurant owner picks up the phone and he's informed that the collector of the district would like to speak to you. So soon the collector comes on board, a male voice, and he introduces himself as a collector of the district and says, sir, I have a batchmate, a young lady, and she's a collector in a different state, in a district of a different state, but we were batchmates. And she has made a request for me to request you to reserve a seat for 20 people coming Sunday for breakfast. And she's given this dosa and this coffee to be served to each and every 20. And we'll be there about 9 o'clock in the morning Sunday. So kindly prepare. And the collector is absolutely humble in his voice. So after the phone is hung up, the restaurant owner is very happy, but he's very, very perplexed as to what just happened. And come Sunday, he's happy, the collector is coming, some other collector is coming. So he's already made all the preparations. The kitchen obviously has made the preparation. And soon, sharp at about 9 o'clock, the cars come, those cars with red lights at that time. And the first person to really exit the cars is a young lady, right, who comes running almost, right, towards the restaurant owner who's at the gate to welcome this group, right? And straight away, she folds her hands and then she goes all the way down to touch the feet of this restaurant owner with both the hands. And the restaurant owner obviously is blessing, but he's very confused now. And you know, he looks at the lady, says, hey, what are you doing? She said, sir, you are not recognizing me. And then she points towards the father. My father and I came here a few years back on the occasion when I had done well in my 10th boards. And my father had brought me here to celebrate. And you were the uncle, the generous man, who not only did not charge for the dosa, you also actually ensured that my father has a dosa and a coffee, and you gave us boxes of sweets, and you made my father distribute the sweets to the customers who were at the restaurant. That gesture encouraged me so much that I strongly feel that was one of the major contributors for me to be able to sustain the effort that I've put in. And now I'm an IAS officer, and sir, with folded hands, I've come here to express my gratitude. And one more thing I request. Today, allow me to pay, because now I can afford to pay, not only for my father and my mother, but for my relatives. And guess what? You know, whenever I narrate this story, you know, I get a bit teary-eyed. These are true stories. And, you know, if we can listen to the same sad, mad stories again and again, I think we can do better if you were to repeat such stories from time to time. So my humble request to all of you is, switch your cell phone, work hard, gambatte kudasai, do your best. Be glad. Because once you are doing things that make you glad and make others glad, that gives the energy, the momentum to overcome things that may make people, including you, mad or sad. Thank you very much. God bless you.